Hello everyone, welcome to the last video in Basic Robotics series. The topics we have been through till now are types of robots, microcontrollers, motors and power supply. And the last concept we should talk about is framework dynamics. It is the most crucial part of structuring of robot. So let's begin. Framework dynamics has four basic elements. The first one is center of gravity of the robot. Second we'll talk about is the distance between the wheel and the robot. Third, the wheel diameter. And fourth, the structure of chassis. Let's talk about center of gravity first. This robot has circuit and battery way above the ground, so the center of gravity is high. Now comparing the robot with six major parameters, we can see that the vibration cancellation due to the road when the CG is high is very good, but due to that, the top speed reduces. Since the CG is very high, grip with the road is less and the vehicle might topple. Talking about the acceleration of the robot, it becomes exponentially less. Next in our list, we have a bot which has very low CG. In this style of the robot, the battery and the circuit is kept very low and closer to the ground. Due to that, the achievable acceleration of the robot is very high and grip to the road is also quite significant. Due to the grip, the braking is also strong and the topple resistance is also less and the top speed is also appreciable. But all these factors lead to one problem. The vibration cancellation of the robot becomes very less and the robot vibrates due to disturbance on the road. Now next in our list is a robot which has wheels very close to the chassis. This kind of robot gets an advantage over grip. They get maximum grip out of all the types of the robot. Toppling resistance, top speed and acceleration is not much affected, but vibration cancellation is less. These type of robots have wheels far away from the chassis. This distance helps the robot to get vibration cancellation due to rough road. But the greater advantage of this is the toppling resistance. Due to wider base, the robot won't topple and would also vibrate less. This will help the robot to get major acceleration compared to other robots. But with greater acceleration, you get less grip and less control over braking. Smaller wheels have two major advantages over any other robot, acceleration and braking. When the wheels are very small, motors have to exert very less energy to get good acceleration and to stop them, hence good braking. But this greater change in acceleration reduces the grip on the road. Since we have smaller wheels, the distance between the base and the ground is less and hence less toppling. Acceleration is very high, the top speed reduces gradually. The wheel tends to expand and over a certain speed, it starts to erode. So we don't get much top speed in this situation. When the robot has larger wheels, it has more advantages and less downsides. Larger wheels gives us more torque, also increases robot's grip on the road. More grip tends to have more vibration cancellation. This also results in better braking. With larger wheels, robot can't take sharp turns, but the turns are very accurate. The only major downside of this property is the acceleration. Due to larger wheels, motors have to exert a lot of energy to get good acceleration. Smaller chassis have very less advantages. Due to smaller chassis, they have better grip. and more toppling resistance. But smaller chassis with better motors have less braking, and due to this, the acceleration is also less. Top speed can be achieved through better investment, but still we can't get much out of it. Now the last type we'll talk about is longer chassis. Longer chassis is very advisable. Longer chassis have very high top speed, but due to that, acceleration and braking is affected. Since the chassis is long, the grip is not much and the vibration cancellation is also very less. But the major downfall is the toppling resistance. Due to larger chassis, a small hit from the side might topple your robot.